Hello, my dear students. Welcome to the today's session. Today we are going to discuss the second part of the overlapping of atomic orbitals. In our yesterday's class, we discussed what is the purpose of overlapping of atomic orbitals. The purpose is what? The purpose or the aim or the goal is to form a covalent bond. So EBT is one of the features is overlapping of atomic orbitals. So how atomic orbitals overlap, to what extent, and one more point I told yesterday was effective overlap brings the stronger bond. So with all these points, today we will continue our discussion on overlapping of atomic orbitals. So once again, I am welcoming you all for the today's session on overlapping of atomic orbitals. See, these are called atomic orbitals overlapping. Okay, overlapping is what? Covering one orbital by the other orbital, or falling of one orbital on the other orbital, or merging of two electronic clouds. So in different way we can explain about the word overlap. Here what is overlapping? Here atomic orbitals are overlapping. Okay, now here there are two types of overlap. One is positive overlap and the other one is what? Negative overlap. What do you mean by positive overlap? Positive overlap is what? See here in this diagram, two atomic orbitals are overlapping. One is pz, other is pz. So two similar p orbitals are overlapping. Okay, what is this plus sign minus indicates? Plus sign indicates these are not mathematical plus and the minus. Okay, don't confuse and don't compare with the mathematical plus sign and the minus sign. Here plus minus indicates availability of electron in this region. Okay, so kindly bring to your mental picture, in a particular atomic orbital, if electron is going for the revolution around the nucleus, keep in mind the quantum mechanical approach. If electron of this atomic orbital is available in this area, and if this orbital's electron is available in this area, then they go for overlap. Or electron of this orbital is here, it is spending some time here, that time, if this orbital comes for the overlap, then it is not called positive overlap. So here positive means what? Availability of electron from the both atomic orbitals. If both orbitals are in a position to overlap, that time if electron is available, that in that region, then it is called as a positive overlap. Okay. What is negative overlap? Negative overlap is not, here electron is available for this orbital, but for this orbital, electron is available this side, other side, opposite side. So here, electron is not available. So atomic, for this atomic orbital, if the electron is not available, then they don't go, though they are overlapping, but bonding is not formed. Why? This orbital with electron, this orbital without electron. So this is called overlap, but bond is not formed. So it is called what? Negative overlap. It is the positive overlaps brings the result. Okay, so all these are called positive overlaps, right? Here pp orbital, this is s and the p orbital, this is pp orbital in the different orientation. Okay, this is x axis, this is y axis, this is z axis, this is, one is on the y axis, other one is on the x axis. But see here, this is called positive overlap. Why positive overlap? Not so, sorry, electron is available, okay, but here why it is called zero overlap? Zero overlap is what? Electron is available here for this orbital, but electron is it available far away. So when the electron is available far away, though the electron availability is there, but they don't go for that type of overlap where bonding is favored. Therefore this is called zero overlap. Here is one more example for the zero overlap. Electron for this is available in this area, in this region, whereas electron availability for this p orbital is in this area. So this is called zero overlap. Okay. and this is first overlap. See, exactly available in the same area, so they overlap. Electron availability and overlapping is happening, so bond is formed here. Here also electron availability and overlapping is also okay, so bonding is formed. Electron availability exactly here in this area, so they overlap, then bonding is formed. You please compare this structure with this structure. Okay, this is p orbital, s orbital, p orbital, s orbital. Okay, so electron is available. Okay, but see the way how they are overlapping. So that means they are not going for the proper overlapping, effective overlapping. Okay, so electronic clouds are not merging properly. So when they are not merging properly, then don't expect formation of the covalent bond. Here you can expect the covalent bond formation. So perturbation indicates electron availability. Okay, and with a proper orientation and effective overlap. So when these three factors are favors, then only covalent bond is formed. Otherwise, no covalent bond. So this is no covalent bond, no covalent bond. Though they are overlapping to some extent, but bonding is not favored, so bond is not formed. In this case, you see available, not available, negative overlap, no bond. Not available, available, overlap is taking place, but no use. Available for this orbital, but not available for this. Available in the different orientation, different direction. So this is also called negative overlap, no bond formation. So here also in the same way, available, not available. Available, not available, in the ulta, in the opposite direction. So these four are examples for negative overlap, totally no bond formation. These four are availability, effective overlap, bond formation. This is availability, but overlapping is not happening in a proper way. So no bond. So no bond, no bond, no bond, no bond, no bond. Only for these two, bond formation is favored. Okay. Very good. Now we'll go for the one more small discussion. Types of overlapping and nature of covalent bond forms. Okay. When two s orbitals are spherical nature, it is imagine, so around the nucleus electron is taking wave nature. Okay, so in 3D, so when these two comes close in contact, electron availability is there. That time if this overlap, this is called SS overlap. How they're overlapping? See, two s orbitals head-on overlap, head-on approach, and head-on approach is there, then bond is formed here. So this is called what? SS bond. Okay, SS overlapping gives SS bond. Which bond? This is covalent bond. So this is SS covalent bond, right? So here only one pair, one electron from this s orbital, one from this, totally one pair is formed. So it is SS overlapping, SS single bond. You see one more. This is S orbital, this is P orbital. Okay, again head on, one is with circle, spherical shape, one is the dumbbell shape, but electron is availability is there here. Okay, please recall the positive overlap. So positive overlap, this is, so one orbital with dumbbell shape, other with circular, so they will approach each other, bond is formed. Okay, this is also head on. Okay, heads are approaching, so this is called internuclear axis of this orbital and axis of this orbital. Please imagine, so they are on the same line. This is called axial overlap, head on overlap. Okay, head on overlap. So this also favors bond formation. What type of bond formed here? This is also one pair is formed here. So one pair electron for this covalent bond. So single bond, this is SS single covalent, SP single covalent. Please here two p orbitals are approaching, two p, one dumbbell shape, other dumbbell shape, head on approach, internuclear distance. Okay, axial overlap. Okay, so these two are overlapping. This is the area where they overlapped, so this is the bond formed here. So here also one pair is there in the overlapping of the two p orbitals. Therefore, this is called pp overlapping. Now, when the overlapping takes place head on, when the overlapping takes place axial, and the bond formed is called what? Sigma bond. So this is called sigma bond. This is a sigma bond. This is also sigma bond. All these are examples for what? Sigma bond. But this is SS single bond, sigma bond. SP sigma bond, single bond. PP sigma bond, single bond, covalent bond. So all these are sigma bond, single bonds. Okay, now you see one more covalent bond. This is called PP overlapping. This is also PP overlapping only, but how they are approaching? Like this, not like this. This is called PP axial, PP head on. This is what? PP sideway. PP sideway. When sideway overlapping is taking place, that bond is called as PP covalent bond. And this bond is formed when this bond forms. Okay. Directly this bond is not formed. When the sigma bond forms, if condition prevails for the extra electrons availability for the sideway overlapping, then only sideway overlapping takes place. Unless axial happens, this will not happen. So first axial, okay, head on happens, that will give the grip, the single bond forms, frame is formed. After forming the frame, then the possibility for the another bond. That means this bond is favored for the multiple bonding. Okay, first sigma bond forms, then they think of going for the double or the triple bond. How? Sideway overlapping. Now when the head on collision, okay, that is axial overlapping, that is called sigma bond, sideway pi bond. Now we will discuss whether pi bond is strong or the sigma bond is strong. That comes under the strength of sigma and the pi bonds. The strength of a covalent bond depends upon amount of overlapping taking place in atomic orbitals at the time of bond formation. How much they are overlapping, okay, with what amount they are overlapping, effective overlapping, I told you, in the same way. So strength of a bond depends upon to what extent they are overlapping. And second one is what? During the formation of a sigma bond, the overlapping of orbitals take place to large extent, but quite less at the time of formation of a pi bond. That means when the sigma bond forms, it is the best way of overlapping, best way of merging. So this is a strong bond. So it means sigma bond is a strong bond compared to the pi bond. Why? Pi bond sideway. Sideway overlapping is not to that much extent compared to the, see here, we have to compare. Both are bond only. But which bond is strong? That depends upon what? That depends upon how much they overlap. Best overlap, next overlap. So this is not so strong. This is a strong bond. So it means sigma bond is strong than the pi bond. Therefore, the sigma bond is stronger than a pi bond. It is interesting to note that pi bond between two atoms is formed in addition to a sigma bond. That means, unless a sigma bond forms, pi bond never forms. Directly, pi bond formation is ruled out. First, a sigma bond forms, main bond is formed, frame is formed, then only side overlapping possibility is there, otherwise no. So fourth point is, it is always present in the molecules having the multiple bond. This point I made very clear. Okay. So unless sigma bond forms, pi bond never forms. So pi bond take place only when there is a possibility of a multiple bonding, that is double or the triple. So that means sigma bond is stronger than the pi bond. Okay. You can easily break the pi bond, but to break the sigma bond we require amount of energy. Okay. So bond enthalpy for the sigma bond is more than the bond enthalpy of the pi bond. So I think today's topic is very clear. So with this we will conclude today's topic. Then in the next class we will discuss some other part of the valence bond theory. Till then, bye.